Za chwilę przedstawię Wam, jak poszczególne inwestycje Wam mogą pomóc w uzyskaniu stałych funduszy na Waszą działalność. Cokolwiek zamierzacie dokonać w Polonii, wymaga to nie tylko Waszej pracy, ale również dobrej bazy finansowej. Most of the projects you are involved in sooner or later will require money. My intention is to make a brief presentation how Polonia can create your own economical base using capital investment projects. I will be using Windsor's Polonia model. Why? It is a successful one, and it was involved, and I was involved in this project for 22 years. So, capital investment project, Windsor Polonia, a successful model. My presentation will focus on the following points. Why capital investment? Brief introduction of the city of Windsor. This is the place of action. How was Windsor $34 million Canadian? I'm not going to repeat that, just you know that from now on. Capital investment creator. Capital, summary of Windsor's Polonia. Summary of Windsor Polonia's capital investment projects. How does it produce money? What are the benefits and the seven steps to success? What is Polonia missing? An economic base to finance all of its activities. How Polonia can make money? It can make money by investing in capital projects. Of course, there are other ways of doing it, a different way of receiving money and receiving support, but this is one of the best, and I will try to explain why. But what is a capital investment? Generally speaking, it refers to money used by business to purchase fixed assets such as land or buildings. Windsor Polonia capital investment model has been successfully developed since the 1980s. These investments create a sustainable economical base to support various Polonia projects which take place in Windsor. Perhaps this successful model can be adopted by Polonia communities worldwide, maybe in your country. Brief introduction of the city of Windsor, Ontario, Canada. It's located in the most southern part of Canada, across from the city of Detroit in the US. Red dot you can see is between Canada and USA. Now, Windsor is the automotive capital of Canada. Unfortunately, it had the highest unemployment rate in Canada for the past 2 years due to current recession, bad news of course. Windsor has the largest border crossing, 40% of trade between Canada and the US coming through Windsor. Windsor soon will be the construction site of the new border crossing costing $1.6 billion. And this is good news. Total costing, if we include the US side, will be approximately $5 billion. Always Canadian, as I mentioned before. Now, just a few pictures how Windsor looks like. This is from Detroit side, so on the left you've got beautiful downtown of Windsor, which is a rather small city. And actually, I missed part, I didn't say how many people is. Population, 200,000. Polish diaspora, 11,500, so relatively small. And now come back to pictures. And we have on the right top is Ambassador Bridge, and on the bottom right is Polish diaspora. So this is the place of action. Let's have a look now how everything started and how they created a capital investment of $34 million. In 1973, a Polish priest organized a meeting for the entire Polish community with the object of creating a capital investment for the future of Polonia. To simplify, I will be using Corporation ABC instead of names, just one I will be naming, which is the main one. In 1978, Corporation A was created, and in 1984, they received a charitable status. Now I move to slide 8. Okay. In 1980, Corporation B was created and received $10 million loan from the Canada Mortgage and Housing Corporation to build a low-income housing complex called Polonia Park. This is Polonia Park. This corporation built 41 buildings with 342 townhouses and apartments on 32 acres of land. In 1985, Corporation, another one, C, built Villa Polonia with three buildings consisting of 69 apartments. And in 1993, Corporation B bought another capital investment, Camelot Gardens in Lymington, which is composed of 25 townhouses for a sum of $1. Interesting. So, now, let's move to the summary of all those investments, capital investments in Windsor. This is a summary of Windsor's Polonia's capital investment. Polonia Park will be 342 units, which I mentioned before, and this is a value at 26 million. Villa Polonia, 69 units. Units, of course, I call townhouses or apartments, and value at 4 million. And Camelot Gardens, 25 units, 2 million. And the Polonia Center, 18 units plus others, would be valued at 2 million. So when we add all together, we have 454 units, or value with value 34 million. So quite a big project. And of course, today the value of the project is lower due to recent recession. And what 454 units represents? If we multiply approximately by 2.5 people per unit or per apartment or per townhouse, we'll provide accommodation for 1,135 people, over 1,000. So this is the scale of this project. And it's owned by Polonia, by the way. I should mention that. And now let me tell you the most important secret, how does it produce money, how our capital investment produces money. Corporation A, and here I'm going to name, is Polonia Center Windsor Inc., owns two companies. One is PC Management, which is responsible for administration of 454 units. So they administrate. And we have another company they own, which is Global Maintenance Company, which is responsible for the maintenance of 454 units. So we have two companies. And all profits from these companies go to support Polish community in Windsor, and its legal way of doing that. Today, this is our gold mine, which benefits our Polonia. Teraz widzicie, jak ten mechanizm działa, jest legalny, że można wy, tak jak my, Windsor tam, mieć capital investment, mieć budynki, nie tylko, prawda, kluto i tak dalej, ale można mieć właśnie apartamenty, które są bardzo dobrą inwestycją. No popatrzmy na benefity. What are the benefits? Today, Corporation A, Polonia Center, Windsor Inc., as provided the Windsor Commission was $600,000. What that means for Canadian community, because we share that, provides accommodation for 1,135 people. By the way, in the 80s and 90s, there was 300 Polish immigrants living in this complex. Provides also permanent employment for 10 workers, so pracowników też możemy utrzymywać. And for example, also other money which was donated to is $30,000 for the University of Windsor Regis Library to buy Polish books in English. And $10,000 for New York Relief Fund after September 11. So we share with others. This is just examples, I cannot list all of them, just time. And what that means for Polonia? $250,000 in scholarship for Polish students in Windsor. $100,000 for renovation of Polish church. And also various donations to Polish organizations, including FOVADIS 1, FOVADIS 2, and FOVADIS 3, $6,000. We have actually students which they receive donations. We have from Windsor delegation here? Hello, yes, shocking, yeah. They are the lucky one, you see, because they pay for them. Super. Also today, beautiful display, I hope, Maria Kiriskudowska. They also donated at least half money for this, so it is another story. So the next slide presents a very special person, which they also support. Huh. They support them. Did you know Polonia Center, Windsor Inc. Corporation, just wait, A, also provided a sponsorship for a girl, she's a Windsorite Polish girl, Katarzyna Dziedzic, who became the 2003 Miss International Canada. Ha, interesting. I know that, by the way. Ona jest nie tylko piękną dziewczyną, ale bardzo mądrą. Powiem wam dlaczego. Dwa fakultety, kryminologię skończyła, prawo skończyła. Pracuje teraz w City of Windsor, tam gdzie moja żona, ale... ale piękną karierę miała właśnie jako miss. And, ciągle zapraszana jest na różne imprezy, także to jest Windsor. To jest poparcie właśnie, gdzie można zrobić fajną rzecz dla tak młodej, utalentowanej, pięknej osoby. To dla was też w przyszłości jest. Już się szykują. Dziękuję bardzo. I jadę dalej. Ostatnia rzecz. Fajny kryterium 7 steps to success. First, leadership. Choose your leader. The person you trust and support. Either professional, businessman, priest, whoever. Tylko jedną rzecz pamiętajcie. Jeżeli wybierzecie tą osobę i macie zaufanie, to już musicie opierać ją. Bo najtrudniejszą rzeczą w tym wszystkim jest pracować razem. Wiecie o tym. Powadzić 1, 2, 3. Wszystko wymaga ciężka praca, jak się razem pracuje. Każda organizacja, tak to jest. I dlatego, jeżeli wybierzecie lidera, to musicie już wspierać go. A propos, powinienem skomentować też Quo Vadis 1, 2, 3, wy macie jakiś dziwny co-chairs. Powiem jedną rzecz, ja osobiście się nie zgadzam z tym, powinien być jeden. Tak jak jest jeden prezydent, jeden generał i tak dalej, i tak dalej. To znaczy w sensie jedna osoba, ale to nauczycie się prędzej czy później, że tak powinno być. Dobrze. Podpowiada mi Monika, że zadziałało, jesteśmy tutaj oczywiście.